Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Minister Paul in Northern California. Come on, Harpo. Harpo decided to join in with us. I want to talk about the difference between Holy Spirit conviction and guilt. First, one of them comes from a Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And the other one comes from a dark spirit, Satan. Conviction is a term that's used to describe how the Holy Spirit points out our sin in our lives and draws us towards repentance. Biblical basis for this starts at John 16:8. You want to make an appearance, Harpo? Come on.
Oh, gotcha.
Oh, gotcha. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. The beautiful kitty, kitty. The beautiful kitty, kitty. Okay, go ahead. John 16:8, and it says this, and when the Holy Spirit comes, he will convict the world concerning sin and righteousness and judgment. Conviction is a process. The Holy Spirit reveals sin to you, and he also will show us how to turn away from sin and how to walk in righteousness. The purpose of this is the step in receiving forgiveness of sins from Jesus Christ. It helps us recognize our imperfections and our inadequacies. And through conviction, we grow closer to God. Closer to God, acknowledging our need for his grace. Okay, that's Holy Spirit conviction. Now guilt. Because it's important to discern between the two. If you've sinned and you've confessed that sin and asked for forgiveness of that sin, you're forgiven. What you may be experiencing now is guilt. Guilt does not come from a Holy Spirit. It originates from Satan. And Satan will exploit the similarity between guilt and conviction just to confuse you. And if there's confusion in it, it's not a God. God said, I'm not the author of confusion. Guilt aims to make you feel hopeless, worthless, and loveless. Unloved, hopeless, worthless. Guilt lacks the positive, critical step of turning that into change. How you can change. It lacks that. It just can. Thank you, Holy Spirit. For I come that you may have life and life more abundantly. Guilt creates a divide between you and Jesus and emphasizes your failures. There is the Harpo right behind me. She's on patrol. Guilt will whisper that you're unforgivable and you're destined to continue to repeat your mistakes. These are some of the lies from the devil. Unlike conviction, guilt doesn't lead to any type of transformation. You'll just sit there in your guilt and start feeling more and more distant from God. That's not Holy Spirit conviction. Conviction will shape you into better followers of Christ. Where guilt seeks to break us down and tear us down, Holy Spirit conviction can build you up and make you not want to sin, not want to continue in that sin. Remember that godly grief leads to repentance and salvation, whereas worldly grief leads to spiritual death. I'm reading from 2 Corinthians 7:9-10. May you be able to discern the difference between Holy Spirit conviction, and may you be able to learn to reject the enemy's guilt, embracing the path of grace and redemption through Jesus Christ our Lord. Help me share this. I know in my heart, saints, that I didn't just randomly just come on here and make this. I know that it's for people out there, and I'd like to reach those people. YouTube has a way of getting in the way of that with algorithms and different ways that they manipulate. I say, let's share, let's like, let's get this information out here, put it on Facebook. Someone may need this word. We're not to live in guilt. And we're not to fight conviction either, though. If the Holy Spirit is, I feel led to say this, if the Holy Spirit is telling you to stop a certain sin, then to you it's sin. If it's guilt, and you play this back, and you hear the difference, then you have to make a decision. You're going to go on in guilt and draw farther, and what'll happen? Hey, man, thank you, Holy Spirit. Because what'll happen in guilt is you'll begin to draw farther and farther and farther away from the Lord. I feel like playing a song, but I know I should end this. I just want to worship. I think I'm going to go live and worship after this. We're going to do worship. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.